Children, welcome to 8th social class. Children, in today's class we are going to learn about hydrosphere. You may heard the word hydrosphere. It refers to a water, right? Hydro in sense water, where we are referring about the water. So what do you mean by hydrosphere? Hydrosphere in the sense the percentage of a water that the earth was surrounded by, okay? And where we are in the geography, we are learning a different structure of the earth, right? How the earth was made up of and what was the inner part of the earth consist, and not only that, outer layer of the earth such as atmosphere we have seen. Now we are going to see hydrosphere, okay? Where, as we know that earth, which is consist of a 71% of the water, remaining percent is a land masses, isn't it, children? So that waterly body, because of the water percentage is more, the earth was classified as a blue planet, waterly planet, isn't it, children? These are the name that the earth consists of, and remaining land masses that we consider as a continental shelf. So here the waterly body, because of the feature of the water which consists on the earth, we refer it as a hydrosphere, okay? Let's see the expansion of the hydrosphere. As we noticed here, 71% of the total land area, which we count in a square kilometer, square feet, that consists of a 361 million square kilometer, it's covered by the water. In percentage, children, it is 71%. When we are calculating it in a square feet, that comes as a 361 million square kilometer. And the major water bodies are Pacific Ocean, Atlantic Ocean, Indian Ocean, and Arctic Ocean. So here the largest water body also we have seen, and the smallest ocean also we have seen. Okay. Then now let's see how the water bodies are classified. Okay. So first, the largest water body is ocean. The ocean are the deep and large expansion of a water found between the continent. Right? See, we know only beaches, isn't it, children? In that beaches also we classify as a ocean and the sea, because the ocean is the largest and deepest expanse of a water found on the continent, in the sense on the earth where we are existing. So example are the Indian Ocean between Asia, Africa and Australia, the Atlantic Ocean between North America, Europe and so on. I'll repeat that. Suppose example that we are in India. We know that India is a continent, subcontinent, right? So the Indian Ocean, we are surrounded between the Asia, Africa, Australia and the Atlantic Ocean, which comes between North America, Europe and so on. That is a blue ocean. So remember, ocean is the largest and deepest water body. Whereas next to ocean, that is the sea. Sea is a part of a ocean extended or projected far in island. So in sea, okay children, remember that in ocean we won't get any island. Okay, it is continuous as a deep and wide. Whereas in sea, where it was extended or projected far on island, in the sense that between the sea we get to see the island. Okay, it was consisted of a island in the sea. Sea are the smaller compared to ocean. Is it clear? First is the ocean, and then compared to ocean, sea is a smaller one. Example are Arabian Sea and the Caspian Sea and the Red Sea. Okay. Then what is Gulf? Okay, next to ocean, second one is sea, then the Gulf. So Gulf is a part of an ocean or a sea that penetrated into land. Is it clear? Gulf in the sense you assume that this is the water one side, this is water another side, were penetrated in the sense separated. The land water body which was separated as a land, that was called as a gar. I'll repeat, the water, two water body which was separated as a land or which consist of land in middle, that was called as a gulf. So see, gulf is a part of an ocean or a sea that penetrated into land. This is a smaller than a sea, okay? When compared to ocean, sea is small, okay? When compared to sea, gulf is a small. So it is surrounded by the water. I repeat children, gulf is surrounded by the water but penetrated in the sense in middle you will get to see the land, okay? The size and shape and depth of the gulf varies from one to another. So it means that you cannot calculate or you cannot compare one gulf to another gulf because it is varies from shape, okay? It is varies from depth as well as a, and it is totally different from one to another. See, not only the Gulf, ocean and sea, you take any part of the globe on the earth, okay? So India is totally different from America, continent Asia is totally different from European continent. So right, so why you will go to other, you take here Mangalore is totally different from the Udupi, isn't it? So like that, here we cannot compare one to another. Like that only one gulf is totally different from a other gulf. So there is a no compare to each other. The example are the Gulf of Manar, the Persian Gulf and the Gulf of Mexico. These are the example of a gulf. So then bay. What do you mean by bay? Bay is, you may heard, bays are very small semi-circular water body partially surrounded by the land. So it is found in form of a semi-circular shape, okay? Semi-circular shape where very rarely or very small part of the land you are get to see. Is it clear? See, what is the difference between gulf to bay? Bay is a, between two water body the land was penetrated, okay? In the sense the land separated the two water body, whereas bay is a semi-circular water body. I repeat, bay is a semi-circular water body, children, where you will get to see very small part of a water land, okay? The depth, extent and size of a bay vary from one to another. This is also same, the bay is different from one bay to another bay. Example, the Bay of Bengal, Bay of Biscay, the Bay of Fundy and Hudson Bay. These are the example for a bay, okay? Then the street. What is the street? A street is a narrow strip of a water body joining the two large water bodies. So bay we have seen, okay? So bay, what do you mean by bay here, children? Bay is a semi-circular water body. Bay is a semi-circular water body. Assume that this is a circle, okay? Where out of that full circle of water body you will get to see very small part of a land, okay? Whereas strip, a narrow strip of a water body, narrow strip in the sense a small thin part of a water, okay? Strip in the sense, what do you mean by like small width of a water body which flow, and that flow of a water finally join the large water body, okay? See, a strip is a narrow strip of a water body joining two large water bodies. So it is a narrow strip, it is a small water strip which finally join the large water body. Example, Park Strait, Kanive, you may have heard Park Kanive, right? Park Strait, Strait of Gibraltar, Bering Strait, these are the strait example, okay? So here children, in ocean, sea, gulf, bay and strait, what you will get to ask? Give an example for gulf, give an example for bay, give an example for strait. So that you have to remember and you have to write, okay? That is for one mark question. Whereas what do you mean by isthmus? This is a one mark question. Isthmus is a narrow stretch of land mass joining to large landmass. Okay, what is the difference here between state and isthmus? See, a state is a narrow strip of water body. Narrow strip of a water body is state, whereas isthmus is narrow stretch of landmass. Okay, this is water and this is the landmass. Okay, and here the water body joining two large water bodies. Okay, whereas isthmus is a landmass joining two landmass only. Very clear. This is a water body. Finally, join the water body only. The flow of a water finally join to water only, which is this strait. Whereas isthmus is narrow stretch, in the sense a small land piece we can see between the water body. Okay, but that water body tightly connect to another land only. I'll repeat once again. See here, a small way of a water flowing. You just imagine, okay? Just you assume that, okay? You assume this picture and you take this water body. When it flow, okay? The flow of a water body finally join to these two other water body, large water body, to join to this only. Okay? Whereas isthmus is landmass only, which join to other landmass only, not to water. Okay? Isthmus is a land piece. Okay? Which continuously join to other land piece only. It end with land piece only, or it connect to land only. It is not going to join to water body. That you have to remember. Here, water body finally is going to join water body only. Whereas this is land piece, finally it connect to land piece only. That is, be clear. Difference between state and isthmus. Okay, isthmus is a narrow stretch of a landmass joining landmasses only. Okay, and what is the importance of a isthmus? Isthmus is most important location for construction of a ocean canal. Okay, why it is important, children? Because it is important for the construction of a canal. Canal, you know, where we can store the water and supply the water. So, example for these canals or the isthmus are Suez Canal between the Mediterranean Sea and the Red Sea. Okay, these canals, Suez Canal is joined between Mediterranean Sea and between the Red Sea. Whereas Panama Canal between Atlantic Ocean and Pacific Ocean. Okay, this is up to strait and isthmus. Then next is relief of the ocean floor. The next topic is ocean floor, because we have seen that ocean is a large expansion of a water body, or we can say that it is a large part of a water which we can get on the earth. Okay, so what is the relief feature of a ocean floor? In the sense, see, we have seen earth, isn't it, children? Earth was first upon the earth, first layer of the earth we get to see crust. Below that mantle is there, below that core is there, right? Like that only we will get to see ocean or a beach. We will get to see a surface of the ocean, but inner ocean, how it was made up of, or how it was divided, or how it was separated as per the depth. Okay, it was separated as per the depth of a water. Okay, the ocean floor is also various features like relief feature upon earth surface. Okay, then the characteristic of ocean floor is divided into four major parts. So as we can get to see three parts of a interior of the earth, here we get to see four different interior of a ocean. They are continental shelf, okay, continental slope, the deep sea plain, and the ocean deep. I'll repeat once again: the continental shelf, the continental slope, the deep sea plain, and ocean deep. Okay, here you see, here coastal area in the sense the landmass where we are existing. This is the landmass. Okay, coastal area refer to the land face, whereas continental self refer to from land, here from the land and here the water body starts. Okay, the land and the water body start. Okay, this is the landmass and here the water body join. Okay, so this part is the continental self, in the sense what the sea or what the water we get to see on the earth, that is the continental self. Only this part we can get to see up to a sea level, your beach, what we get to see, that is the continental self. And this is the continental slope. This is the continental slope, and that is we can say continental crust also. Okay, the continental slope we will also call it as a continental crust. Then the third part is continental rise. See, continental self in the sense the water is remaining on the surface of the earth. Okay, when the water will flow as a slant. Okay, this is the that slant of a water we will call it as a continental slope. Okay, then here the third layer was continental rise. This is continental rise. Continental rise in the sense, see here first you take it example, simple example. When you drop, when you pour a water, it is in a flat surface. Okay, then slowly that water started to flow. Okay, that slope finally settled in down. Okay, here water is. You poured water here, that will take a shape of a slant. Again, that water here it will land. It will land in the sense that will be final. Final in the sense water is there, that will flow to down, and that down water will come and settle here. That will call as a continental rise, and that will continue as a deep sea plain. Okay. Now let's see the explanation of that part. Okay, see that same what picture you can see in your textbook. This is a continental, this is a land, continental self and the ocean deep, continental slope, ocean deep is here, continental self to continental slope, ocean deep continues. See the same here, land and sand. When you get into a beach, you will get to see this part. Okay, certain area when you land on a ocean, you will get to see sand part to walk. Okay, as you continue, for you the deep or the depth of a water get to start. That is a continental slope. But then the deep part, deeper part of the ocean is started. Okay, what is continental self? So the continental slope is shallow water area along the sea coast, in the sense shallow, in the sense not much more deep. Okay, where we can walk. And here what you have to remember, the average depth of the continental self is 100 fathom. 100 fathom in the sense 1 fathom is equal to 60 feet. So 1 fathom is equal to 60 feet. So you have to calculate 100 into 6 feet. So that was the total depth of a continental self. Okay, the depth of a sea in this region gradually increase towards the continental slope. So here the depth of the self continue, the flow of a water is continue as the water getting to down the part. When it's come to down the, that becomes a continental slope. From there onwards the slope or the deep of a water increase. So why the important, or what is the important of a continental self? That we can say it is important for fishing, aquaculture in the sense all the fishes that live here, aquaculture, navigation and extraction of a mineral. Importance of a continental slope, because of the fishing, aquacultural life, navigation and extraction of a mineral. Okay, then what is a continental slope? The water is was stagnant here, that will take a flow, and that flow become here continental slope. Okay, this is the second part of a ocean floor and very steep in the sense deep. This link between the continental self and the deep plate. So this is the link between continental self and deep sea plate. Okay, and we can see a deep or the depth of a water. And then the third one is the deep sea plain. This is a vast plain found at the bottom of a sea floor, and the deep sea plain is also known as alluvial plain, and it covers largest area of a ocean floor. This region is sea mound and Gadon or Phone, in the sense that, see here, look at this picture. See here, when the continentals start, okay, then the water will take a shape of a flowing dock. Okay, here in these particular ages, see up to here, from here to here, that is a continental slope. Okay children, where here you can see the navigation, extract of a mineral or aqua marine life are existing. Fishing will take place in this region. Okay, and next comes continental rise and deep plain. In the sense, a down up part of the ocean where it is deepest and it is continuous. This part. Okay, that is what explained here. See, the largest area of the ocean floor, in the sense it is a continuous wide, and these region are sea mounded girt and or found. Then the fourth one is the ocean deep. The ocean deep are also called as the ocean trench. These are deepest part of the ocean floor. Is it clear? This is a ocean deep, is a deepest part. When compared to deep sea plain, ocean deep is more deeper, and these challenge the deep of marine trench in the specific ocean near Philippine Island is called 11,033 meter deep. The depth of that trench, in the sense depth, you know, or specific Philippine Island, it was found that was 11,033 meter deep, and this is deepest point of the Philippine Ocean. Okay, the Philippine Ocean depth has been found, that was 11,033 meters. Okay, other trench are Tonga trench, Karail trench, and specific trench. It means, see, these are the trench. What do you mean by trench? Trench was a deepest point of a ocean. Okay, see, they have given Philippine trench, they are given. This is the first deepest part. Along with that, another trench is also there. That was Tonga trench, Coral trench, and specific ocean trench is also there. Okay, that is an example for ocean deep. Then, what is the temperature? What do you mean by temperature? We have seen temperature on the earth, right? So we have know the temperature which will depend on the latitude, longitude, and the near the equator region. So here temperature refer to a temperature, or the temperature inside the earth we are referring. It means that how the sunrise will reach the ocean, whether inside the marine the water get heat, or the aqua life or the fishes are living inside that water, whether they are able to face the temperature. This is about the temperature. Okay, temperature of the sea water or water temperature varies according to latitude. As I told, on the earth, even in the ocean, temperature which was depend upon mainly on the latitude and the depth of a ocean floor. Okay, so mainly it is a latitude in the sense the ocean which was near to the sunrise, that was referred to latitude, and the depth of a ocean. Ocean in the sense, see, we are not referring particularly any one or two ocean. Okay, any ocean which was deep, which is most deepest ocean, which is the shallowest ocean, depending upon that the temperature of the ocean is calculated. The temperature ocean water near the equator is more. So we can see that the temperature of the ocean near the equator in the sense middle part of the earth, isn't it children? The ocean which comes in the middle part of the earth, that has more temperature. Okay, see, the water near the equator more, then the temperature near the Arctic and Antarctic circle are less. So Arctic circle comes up and down once. So these the circles where it feel the less temperature, which increase the depth of the temperature of the water decrease. Then because of the sunlight, the penetrate into ocean only up to the depth of 200 meters. So it says that here on the ocean, the sunlight can reach only up to 200 meters, not more than that. So below that, the temperature is very less. I repeat that here sunlight which can reach into the water only up to 200 meters. Okay, and remember that only up to 200 meters where continental slope take place. Okay, remember that up to only continental slope the sunrise reach, so that we can see their navigation, extract of a mineral, or the fishing, or the all the marine life will live exist there because of the sunlight. Below that there is a darkness. Okay, within these that various marine organisms are found in a large number. As we require sunlight on the earth, the marine life or the plants which exist in the water or the life which exist in the water, they too require the sunlight. Because of that only they will exist in the continental slope. Okay, so it is clear that in the continental shelf as well as the continental slope, they will get the sunrise. Remaining to ocean deep, ocean plain, they won't get the sunlight. Okay, there we can see the darkness. Then the next one is salinity. You may heard this term in science. Salinity refer to the percentage of a salt dissolved in a water. That is a simple term. What do you mean by salinity? Salinity refer to the percentage of a water dissolved in a water. Okay, so salinity is the percentage of a salt dissolved in a sea or a ocean. This is one more question, very important. What do you mean by salinity? Salinity is the percentage of a salt water dissolved in a sea or a ocean water. Okay, how to calculate the salinity? The average salinity of the ocean water is 35 ppt. In the sense, average, in the sense, at least minimum percentage of the saltiness should be remain in the water. That was calculated as a 35 ppt. What do you mean by ppt? Parts per thousand. So here 35 gram divided by 100 grams, that we can see on a ocean. That is the average salinity that we can get into the ocean water. And salinity of a ocean water is very high near the tropic. So remember that near the tropic region, the saltiness of the water is very more, whereas it is very low in the pole. Pole in the sense which comes in the top on the end of the globe, Earth. There the salinity or saltiness of the water is very less in a pole region. Okay, at the equatorial region, the salinity of the average is very average, in the sense medium. Neither it is very high like a tropic, nor it is less like a pole. It is average in a tropic because of the evaporation and precipitation of a sunlight. Is it clear? Because of the precipitation and evaporation of a water because of the sunlight, equatorial region has get medium level of a saltiness in the water. Very easy salinity topic, 1 mark, or if suppose it come for 2 mark also, you can write. So remaining part like ocean current, tide, all that we are going to refer in the next class. Now today, very important and a small topic that we learned, that is different type of a water bodies. Okay, different type of a water body like ocean, sea, gulf, bay, strait, isthmus. Then important feature of a ocean like continental shelf, continental slope, continental rise and ocean deep. The depth of these features also we have seen, and the features also we have seen, and temperature and salinity. This what we have referred today. You read the lesson once, and importance bay, strait that you underline. Okay, I'll meet you in the next class, children. Till then, read well, take care.